thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to the Cathedral of Our Lady of the Angels. We thank you so much for being here with us today as we celebrate this wonderful Mass. We ask to please silence any cell phones or electronic devices that you may have with you this morning, just so we can best enjoy our prayer together. And as we begin, we invite you to please rise and join us as we sing our gathering hymn found in your worship aids.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
So we are gathered today to especially celebrate the centenary of the Legion of Mary. It is a beautiful day as we celebrate this anniversary, but it is also beautiful because today, in the Archdiocese of Los Angeles, we celebrate the Feast of Our Lady of the Angels. So let's especially go to our Blessed, the intercession of our Blessed Mother, that we continue to be faithful sons and daughters of God, and bring the beauty of the devotion to our Blessed Mother to the people of our time. So let's start our celebration, acknowledging our sins, and preparing ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. I confess,
my God,
and to you, my brothers
and sisters,
that I have greatly sinned
in my thoughts and in my words,
and what I have done,
what I have attempted,
through my fault, through my mysterious fault.
Therefore I ask, as Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my
brothers and sisters, to pray for me, O Lord our God. May
Mary
God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
To
us pray. Grant, Lord God, that we, your servants, may rejoice in unfailing health of mind and body, and through the glorious intercession of Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, Our Lady of the Angels, may we be set free from present sorrow and come to enjoy eternal happiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing. As they rejoice before you, as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed, as on the day of Midian. For a child is born to us, a son is given. Upon his shoulder, dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful, from David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
And look looks upon the heavens and the earth below. Blessed be the name of the Lord forever, forever. He raises up the lonely from the dust. From the dunghill he lifts up the poor to seat them with princes, with the princes of his own people. Blessed be the name of the Lord forever,
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, so that we might receive adoption as proof that you are children. God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a child. And if a child, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
Gospel according to Luke. The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to Mary, the angel said, Hail, favored one, the Lord is with you. But Mary was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom, there will be no end. But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, como decía, nos reunimos hoy para celebrar el centenario de la Legión de María, en este día que aquí en la Arquidiócesis celebramos Nuestra Señora de los Ángeles. So it is a special joy to be together for this beautiful celebration. So as we hear in the first reading today from the prophet Isaiah, "You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing." So we rejoice today with the Universal Church, but with Mary Immaculate, Mediatrix of all graces. For this past century, the Legion of Mary has been a beautiful sign of our filial love for the Blessed Virgin Mary and for her maternal love for us. Today, we especially invoke the prayers of Our Lady and also the founder of the Legion of Mary, the servant of God, Frank Duff, who was a true son of Mary and a great pioneer in the lay apostolate. So I will say that this year, 2021, is truly a Marian year. Not only are we celebrating the centennial of the Legion of Mary in nations all over the world, but as you know, next week here in the Archdiocese, we begin our Jubilee year to mark the 250th anniversary of Mission San Gabriel Arcangel, which St. Junipero of Serra founded on the Feast of the Nativity of the Blessed Virgin Mary, September 8, 1771. And that doesn't convince us that this is really a beautiful Marian year. Later this year, during Advent, we will celebrate the 490th anniversary of Our Lady of Guadalupe's apparition to Saint Juan Diego. And we celebrate at that moment in a special way the beginning of the evangelization of the Americas. So I think it is a beautiful Marian year that we are celebrating. And it's beautiful too, as I said before, to be together today, just keeping that in mind. So in this moment when we reflect on Mary, our Blessed Mother, we need to invoke her and ask her to strengthen us to meet the spiritual challenges we face in the world today. Immaculate Mary is the one who brings us Jesus Christ in every time and every place. This is the beautiful role that God has given her in salvation history. And this is the beautiful role that she plays in each one of our lives. St. Paul says today, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his son, born of a woman, so we might receive adoption. As proof that you are children of God, that you are children, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. God sends Mary into the world to bring his children hope. Through her maternal love and intercession, God fulfills the ancient prophecies. God sent his Son, born of a woman, to bring light into the darkness. The darkness of this world without God. The darkness of the human heart without Christ. And through Mary is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah that we hear in today's first reading. For a child is born to us, a son is given to us. And my dear brothers and sisters, in this son, in this child, you and I become God's own sons and daughters. This is the beautiful truth of our lives. We are children of God, and we are children of Mary, born of Mary and the Holy Spirit. This is the beautiful truth that the servant of God, Frank Duff, understood. Now, anniversaries are always a time to make new resolutions, to make promises of renewal. I've been thinking a lot about that lately as we approach this Jubilee year here in the Archdiocese. Because a Jubilee is a season of mercy and a season of grace. And as we know, God pours out his graces upon us through Mary, the mediatrix of all grace. So during this year, this so many beautiful celebrations, let us open our hearts to his graces. Let us use this moment to make a new beginning, to renew our awareness of our spiritual childhood in Mary. And let us rededicate ourselves to spread the light of Jesus Christ in the darkness of our world. Let us make those words of Mary our own this year. Let us, each one of us, say, Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word. In this Jubilee year, we have a beautiful opportunity to renew the love in our souls for Christ. To renew our desire to serve him with all our hearts and all our strength. My brothers and sisters, in a sense, the world needs a new annunciation. Just as Immaculate Mary did, let us open our hearts to the love of God and open our lives to serve his beautiful plan of salvation and to bring Jesus Christ into the world. Our world, our city, our country needs Jesus. So many have turned away and forgotten him. But their souls are crying out for Christ to meet him again or to meet him for the first time. We need to speak of Christ to our neighbors, to speak of his love in our lives, to speak of his mercy. There is nothing more powerful than the truth about our Lord Jesus Christ. Nothing more beautiful than to know his love and to share it with others. But my dear brothers and sisters, as we know, we cannot carry out our mission unless we are men and women of prayer. The founder of the Legion of Mary had a great love for the Rosary, as we know. He urged us to say it reverently, I will say daily, and to have the prayers of the Rosary constantly on our lips as we go through our daily lives. So let us ask Mary, our Blessed Mother, to win for us the grace to renew our love for the Holy Rosary. And as we give thanks to God today for this century of grace and blessings, let us entrust ourselves to Mary Immaculate, Mediatrix of all grace. May she intercede and make this season of grace for all of us, that we may begin again to know and value the great gift of our Catholic faith, the beauty of living as children of God, as children of Mary, our Blessed Mother. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My brothers and sisters, confident in God's love and mercy, we present our prayers together as with one voice and lift them up to Him.
For Pope Francis, Archbishop Gomez, and all the clergy, may the fiat of the Lord of Our Lady of the Angels inspire them to respond as Christ bids them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, may the Holy Spirit guide them according to His will. Let us pray to the Lord. For the Consilium Legionis Maria and its affiliates throughout the world, may it renew its charism to the spiritual works of mercy during its centenary. Let us pray to the Lord. For the Los Angeles Senatus, may the standard of Our Lady unify us to bring souls to the Church and the Legion. Let us pray to the Lord. For all those experiencing suffering in mind, spirit, or body as a result of the pandemic, may their distress lead them to examine their lives and hear the still, small voice of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, may God peace be with them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Almighty Father, you provide for our every need. Hear our prayers today and answer them. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Kindly be seated. We are always grateful for your generosity to your Cathedral of Our Lady of the Angels. Please take a few moments to prayerfully consider your offertory gift to God in thanksgiving for the many blessings you have received. And those joining virtually may donate by going to the link that appears on your screen. And those present will have an opportunity after Mass to place your donations in the basket located at the exits of the cathedral. Thank you for your generosity.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we ask, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that through the intercession of Blessed Mary, Our Lady of the Angels, the Mother of your Son, no petition may go unanswered, nor request be made in vain. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
right and just, our dear and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the feast day of Our Lady of the Angels. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Indeed, Holy Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give light to all things and made them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, that from the rising of the sun to its setting, pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts, are brought to you for consecration, they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup,
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wonderful resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose aid you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, our spouse, with your blessed apostles and the glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. This day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Teach us love, teach us wisdom. righteous love.
Thank you.
Let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech, O Lord, your mercy, that we, who rejoice and commemorate the Blessed Virgin Mary, Our Lady of the Angels, may, by imitating her, share worthily the mystery of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I understand that there are no announcements, so we are lucky today. Okay, one announcement. Brief announcement. Thank you. I think you need a microphone, so can we get a microphone for him? Same price.
Two very quick things. First, I'd like to thank you, Your Excellency, for being here today. We very much appreciate your presence and giving the Mass to us for the centenary for the Legion of Mary.
Thank you.
And the second really quick announcement is, for all of you that are here from the Legion of Mary, please, after the recessional, please stay in your seats. We have a very quick little gift to be able to give you today. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. So, it was a good announcement. You are going to get a gift. So I also want to thank my brother priest for being here today, and my brother deacons, and especially to our choir today. Thank you very much. So let us continue to celebrate this beautiful anniversary of the centenary of the Legion of Mary. And also, as we start the Jubilee year, it's a great opportunity, as I was saying before, to grow in our love and devotion to Mary, our Blessed Mother. Obviously, the beautiful thing is praying the Rosary every day. It's a beautiful saying from a saint that in Spanish it says, A Jesús se va y se vuelve por María. To Jesus we go and come back through Mary. So let us continue to grow in, as I said, in our devotion to Mary and helping people to see the beauty of her intercession and the beauty of having Jesus in the center of our lives. The Lord be with you.
Bow your head for the blessing.
May God, who through the childbearing of the Blessed Virgin Mary, will in his great kindness to redeem the human race, be pleased to enrich you with his blessing.
Amen.
Amen. You know always and everywhere the protection of her, through whom you have been found worthy to receive the altar of life. May you, who have devoutly gathered on this day, carry away with you the gifts of spiritual joys and heavenly rewards.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.